Hi, it's Katrina. Number 10, the Devil's Helmet. The Devil's Helmet is one of the strangest artifacts from the days of King Henry VIII. This odd helmet was actually part of a full armor set crafted by the Austrian blacksmith Konrad Susenhofer. This suit was lighter than most suits of armor back then, with intricate details in bronze, gold, and silver. It was such a valued treasure that Maximilian I, the Holy Roman Emperor, gave it to Henry in 1514 as a gift. Henry VIII is remembered as being a ruthless ruler and for his tumultuous love life in his quest for an heir. He also did the unimaginable by breaking the relationship between England and the Roman Catholic Church when the Pope refused his request for an annulment from his first wife, Catherine of Aragon. He broke with the Church and became the supreme head of the Church of England, got a divorce, and married Anne Boleyn. But all that is a story for another day. King Henry VIII also had a famously huge appetite, and most likely had diabetes, gout, an infected leg with ulcers, and gained tons of weight as he got older. The young Henry VIII was beloved by his people and handsome, but as the years went by, his closest friends questioned his mental health, and many of them lost their lives. He had what some historians say was probably the highest sugar content in his diet for anyone in the 16th century. When King Henry died in 1547 at the age of 55, he was just over 300 pounds and very sick. His corpse had to be soaked in perfume before the funeral because it stank so badly. During his years as a fighter, Henry wanted to be known as a brave warrior king and loved new inventions and innovations in armor. He loved this particular armor so much that he started wearing the disturbing helmet with the curled devil horns in court meetings. King Henry even had his personal blacksmith install reading glasses on the helmet so that he could read documents without taking the bulky thing off. After Henry died, the helmet went to his favorite jester, who later sent it to Leeds to be put on display, where it remains to this very day. Number 9. Coins in a prayer book. At an Irish bookstore in Galway called Kenny's Bookshop, a strange and unexpected discovery was made in a very old prayer book. Sarah Gallagher, an archivist at the shop, was cataloging a recently procured diocesan library when she came across two mysterious gold coins hidden inside the spine of a book. Surprisingly, the coins came from Mexico, and they are made of solid gold. The coins are dated between 1821 and 1947. This was strange, especially since the newly acquired books have little monetary value. It was only by chance that Sarah removed the cover and the coins fell out, and the mystery began. We don't know why these mysterious gold coins were hidden inside a prayer book. Even more confusing is how they made it from Mexico all the way to Ireland. The owner of the store, Thomas Kenny, believes the coins probably belonged to a Catholic priest in Mexico who had to make a quick escape in the early part of the 20th century. But for whatever reason, the coins got stuck in the book, got lost in a church collection, and then the collection was sold off. Number 8. The Blood Red Sky. In May 2022, citizens in China walked outside to discover the sky the color of blood. The sky glowed blood red as confused villagers looked toward the heavens in amazement. It transformed the ordinary night sky into something out of a biblical horror movie. This happened in the eastern Chinese city of Zhoushan, and while it definitely freaked out the residents who had wandered into the streets with their eyes turned to the sky, wondering if the end was coming, it wasn't actually that big of a deal. There was a perfectly good explanation for the blood red sky. According to weather experts, the fog and clouds of that particularly wet night 1 week before Friday the 13th caused the redness. Experts believe there was a fishing boat in the city harbor with one extremely powerful red light on it. That red light shone into the fog, and the cloud became exaggerated because of the rain and had a kind of prism effect. Because of all the aerosols in the atmosphere, they scattered the light from the fishing boat through the entire sky, turning the sky red. It wasn't an omen of the end of times, just a strange optical illusion that really scared everyone. And now for number 7, but first, it's shout-out time! Big thank you to Ivan and Vincent Dorr for supporting this channel. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already to join the Origins Explained family. Number 7. Medieval Book Coffer. An extremely rare French Gothic coffer dating back to the 1400s was just recently discovered. This extraordinarily rare box is 600 years old and was used for holding books. It was a medieval book coffer, something that a person could pack full of their favorite books, clasp shut, and then carry around with them. It was basically a really heavy Kindle, but a really long time ago and without the need for charging. The mysterious coffer was just acquired by Oxford's Bodleian Libraries. It's the first book box of its kind ever to be held by the library, which has a massive collection of medieval manuscripts. It's not entirely clear where the thing came from, but seems to have originated in Paris after 1491. The box is made of wood, covered in a soft layer of leather, and has a metal lock and fittings. Everything was protected by a red canvas lining that has survived almost intact. There are even leather straps on the sides to make it easier to carry. Inside the lid, there is a woodcut of the God the Father in Majesty. This illustration came from a book on liturgy printed in 1491, which is where we get the original date of the coffer. The illustration was probably meant to provide spiritual protection to the owner of the coffer, and to the books and whatever other documents they would keep inside the box. Christina Dondi, professor of early European book heritage at Oxford, said to be able to study something like this is truly extraordinary. This coffer dates to a time when devotional resources were at the intersection between medieval and modern periods, between art made by hand and by the use of machines. Number 6. Ancient bow and arrow. According to a new study that's just been published in the journal Science Advances, the earliest human inhabitants of tropical rainforests in Asia were packing some serious heat. 130 arrowheads dating back over 48,000 years were discovered in a very unexpected place. The arrowheads made from solid bone were found in a cave in Sri Lanka. That makes them the oldest projectiles discovered outside of Africa, showing that Sri Lankans were the first people outside Africa to come up with long-distance weapons for hunting and warfare. Even more amazing, the researchers discovered other advanced tools along with the bone arrowheads. They found primitive tools for making clothing, showing an advanced and sophisticated civilization here nearly 50,000 years ago. They may have lived in a cave, but at least they could make their own clothes and shoot each other with arrows. Finally, researchers believe these projectiles were used primarily for hunting monkeys, but they also found that some of them increased in length over time, showing that later generations of hunters started taking on bigger game, like pigs and deer. Number 5. Historic log cabin. In Scott County, Kentucky, a couple of homeowners demolished a historic house that's been around for over two centuries. According to Scott County historian Anne Bolton Bevins, the house was probably built around 1787, likely by a man named Israel Grant. He was one of the very first settlers in Kentucky, married to the sister of legendary Daniel Boone. But with the passing of time and as the real estate market grew red hot in 2022, the owners of the home sold the property. This led to them having to demolish the entire house. But as they were tearing the house down, they made a shocking discovery. Hidden inside the walls of the house were the remnants of an even older log cabin. Someone had built this log cabin over 235 years ago, then integrated it into an actual house when they decided to upgrade. Back then, you could more or less stick a flag in the ground and claim land, then build your house out of the nearby trees, and that's what happened here. While you might think that such construction would fall apart, that's not the case. The original log cabin remained hidden, undamaged, and responsible for the structural integrity of the house for about as long as the United States has been a country. To preserve what they have found, workers have begun the deconstruction process, and they will catalog each piece and place it in secure storage until a new place can be located to rebuild it. Number 4. The Tudor Gun Shield. In the 16th century, King Henry wasn't the only one who had some cool armaments. Those who guarded the king also had some pretty advanced military technology to protect the monarch. They had gun shields, huge metal shields about the size of a garbage can lid, designed with a hole in its center to fit a matchlock pistol. It was a genuine shield and a gun in one. The personal bodyguards of King Henry VIII would wield these shields, designed to be important for protection while giving them ample space to line up a clear shot. After the king died, the royal armory held on to 35 of these gun shields, and while we don't know how many still survive to this day, there are at least three on display at the famous Tower of London, and another being stored at Windsor Castle. Just recently, one of these shields went up for auction. It was put up for around $50,000 and was the first one to be found on the market since the 1970s. Number 3. weird giraffoid. Scientists have wondered for decades just why the world's giraffes developed such extraordinarily long necks. Now, thanks to a recent discovery of an ancient giraffe fossil, we might just have the answers. Scientists with the Chinese Academy of Sciences just discovered the fossilized remains of an ancient cousin of our modern giraffe. This thing roamed Earth 17 million years ago, and it had an incredibly long neck. To understand what's so confusing about the long neck of the giraffe, we have to look at evolutionary science. Some scientists have always thought giraffes have long necks simply so they can feed on trees. The giraffes with longer necks can eat more food and may pass on the genes to their kids. It's all about improving the chance of survival. But other scientists believe it has more to do with reproductive success. They believe a longer neck is more attractive to giraffe females, and so these giraffes have more opportunities to reproduce. The longer necks also make them better fighters, so they can literally beat away the competition with their heads. Thanks to this new fossil, researchers believe it comes down to fighting. By looking at the bones of this prehistoric giraffe, scientists found it had an extremely thick and bony skull, which is used in vigorous combat with other enormous giraffes. These guys literally beat their heads against each other. So while the long neck may help to reach delicious leaves up in the trees, the real purpose of the long neck may have always been for battle. Number 2. The pendant. A unique amulet was just discovered in England, and archaeologists have declared it a national treasure. The amulet was found in the UK, initially uncovered by a woman with a metal detector named Wendy Thompson during Christmas of 2020. Wendy was searching for any potential artifacts near a small farm when she came upon the artifact. It dates sometime between 43 AD and 410 AD, or the entire occupation of Britain by the Roman Empire. It has been lying in the dirt in a random field for about 2,000 years, and its date has already been verified by the British Museum, which authenticated the artifact as 100% legitimate. Number 1. Message in a bottle. In April 2022, a message in a bottle was launched from Hatteras Village in North Carolina. Philip Wise, who had been visiting the area from Virginia, tried all morning to send the message in the bottle out to the ocean with his son, but the Atlantic just kept throwing it back onto the shore. They finally had to go down to the landing marina and throw it into the ocean there. But honestly, they never really thought anyone would ever see that message. And sadly, it was found the next day by another beachgoer. But they added their own message, resealed the bottle, and then sent it back into the ocean. A few months later, in June, the message in a bottle was discovered 700 miles away from where it originally started its journey, washed up in Cape Cod, Massachusetts. It was discovered by a local on Tuckernuck Island named Samuel Southworth. He saw the first two messages, realized what was going on, and added his own. He drew a small picture of a whale, folded it up, put all the messages back in the bottle, and threw it into the ocean. Only time will tell if anyone else finds the messages in the bottle. And seeing how unpredictable the weather has been lately, nobody can really say just where in the world this thing might end up next, so keep an eye out. What message would you leave in the bottle? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. See you soon. Bye.